I think our Bihar press conference, and today it is for sharing the details of elections to state assembly elections to Assam, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Puducherry, Union Territory of Puducherry. My only request is that after I finish, Shefaliji will take the floor. As always, if we all kind of raise our hand, identify ourselves and ask questions one by one, we'll all be able to hear the replies and there'll be no disturbance. We always got this cooperation from you and I solicit the same this time also. Normally the onset of a new year symbolizes hope, cheer and happiness. 2021 has ushered in something more valuable, post-COVID, resilience, solidarity and a sense of global community. Amid the challenges of COVID, please switch off the mobiles if possible. Amid the challenges of our, keep them on silent. Amid the challenges of COVID-19 that we still continue to face, we shall find immense comfort in the stories of hope and see value in the positive and encouraging lessons that are emerging in the post-COVID world. This period of unprecedented health crisis will be also be remembered for the innumerable acts of courage, compassion, selflessness by the so-called ordinary people doing most extraordinary acts. I hope you will allow me, but our individual and collective tributes to the COVID warriors and heroes, doctors, paramedic staff, nurses, researchers, scientists, and last but not the least, from ECI point of view, all our officials on the election duty who are located in the front line, right up to the polling station level, and trying to kind of see the process through. With keeping all this in mind, we have kept the leitmotif and theme of National Voters Day 2021, making our voters safe, empowered, informed and vigilant. Last year, when the entire world was confronted with an unprecedented crisis in the form of COVID-19, a whole lot of election management bodies across the democracies were faced with a tough predicament of how to balance the democratic rights of citizens to choose their representatives while also preserving and protecting the health and safety of the people. Many countries hazarded to venture and took the courageous route in spite of these circumstances to venture and took courageous decision to go ahead with the elections with some adjustments in the election schedules and other precautions. In the thick of this pandemic, ECI started the kind of test trials with 18 election to 18 seats of Rajya Sabha on June 19, 2020. Admittedly, the electoral college is very limited, but that was a kind of way of starting the process. But after that and some legislative council elections came the challenge of Bihar. With 7.3 crore electorate of Bihar, it was indeed a watershed moment for ECI. It proved to be a kind of litmus test. We have been going under litmus tests before, but this was quite different. And I am glad to report to you that the electorate of Bihar reposed their confidence in the extensive sanitization and health safety measures put in place at polling stations. I would be failing in my duty if I don't tell you that many of our collectors, they suffered from COVID in Bihar, rejoined their duties and saw the process through. One divisional commissioner had this problem. She was still manning two divisions. One IG, unfortunately, he passed away due to COVID and other comorbidities. We requested his wife and his daughter to come here for National Voters Day Award, which was given on a virtual basis by Honorable President of India. I also have with me here Chandrabhushan Kumar, who was in charge of COVID, who is sitting on this side, so you can see him. I would request the CEO of Bihar to just stand up and be counted. They are the people who really put in day in and day out to carry the entire process through. In fact, you will be glad to know, and you must be already aware, that voter turnout in assembly elections in Bihar 2020, 57.34%, exceeded both the previous assembly election of 2015 as well as Lok Sabha elections 2019. And I would like also to report to you that women voters turned out in very large numbers, 59.69%. Even while the ECI was grappling with the Bihar election, a core team of dedicated officers led by Shri Umesh Sinha was already working on these five elections for which we are in front of you today. Actually, they have a system of series of meetings with the officials of Home Ministry regarding the availability of forces, officials of railway regarding the coaches which are required for transportation of the CPFs, postal department people, and any other department whose services may be required for the smooth conduct of elections. And they start their preparation very quietly months before the actual process. It culminates in the form of a formal announcement. Even otherwise, as a part of the background, besides the background meetings, Shri Umesh Sinha, Secretary General, personally visited Tamil Nadu and Puducherry in January. Shri Dharmendra Sharma, Senior DEC, visited Assam in January and February. Shri Sudeep Jain, DEC, who besides being the DEC in charge of EVMs, is also in charge of West Bengal, he visited in January and December. Full commission visited all the five poll going states and UT of Puducherry in January and February. We started with Assam, then came to West Bengal. After an interval of about 5-6 days, we went to Tamil Nadu, Puducherry and Kerala. And our system is that we start with interactive interaction with the political parties and entities, because the firm belief of the commission is that after a voter, it's the political parties and entities who actually form the bedrock of the entire electoral process. After that, we listen to the field officers. We also talk to the regulatory agencies of both Government of India as well as the state government. We culminate our meeting, official meetings, with the meeting with the Chief Secretary, DGP, senior officers of that state. And finally, we end the visit with a briefing to the media, as was done in all these five states. I must compliment the voters whose trust in India's democratic system, resolved to articulate their electoral choice and firm determination to participate is inspiring. They brave several odds and difficulties, personal, domestic, professional, sometimes even barriers, to come out on the election day to mark their votes at the polling station. In fact, if you recall, a whole lot of you attended the NVD this time also, as you do every year, we have prepared an entire collage around the common man of R.K. Lakshman to kind of explain and convey the ECI's ethos of how we perceive the elections. The terms of Assam is up to 31st May 2021. Number of assembly seats is 126. Please tell me if you don't catch me, I'll speak again. Term of Assam is 31st May 2021. Number of assembly seats is 126. Reserved seats, SC, 8. ST, 16. Term of Tamil Nadu is 24th May 2021. Number of assembly seats, 234. Reserved seats, SC, 44. ST, 2. West Bengal, term of assembly is up to 30th May 2021. Number of assembly seats is 294. SC seats are 68, ST seats are 16. Kerala, the term is up to 1st June. Number of assembly seats is 140. Reserved seats are 14 and for SC and 2 for ST. Puducherry, the term is up to 8th June. Number of assembly seats is 30. Reserved seats, SC 5. ST nil. A total of 824 assembly constituencies shall be going for polls during these elections. 18.68 crore electors will cast vote at 2.7 lakh polling stations in these states and UT of Puducherry. More than 3 lakh service vote electors will be availing the facility of electronic transmitted postal ballot system, that is ETPBS. The special summary revision was held with respect to 1/1/21 as the qualifying date and the electoral roll published in January 2021 itself. Because we have reduced due to COVID, we used to have a polling station with maximum 1,500. Now we have made the qualifying thing to be 1,000. We have also ensured that all polling stations are on the ground floor. That is completely non-negotiable. So Assam, the polling stations in 2016 were 24,890. 2021, 33,530. Percentage increase in polling stations, 34.71. Tamil Nadu, we had 66,007 polling stations. Number of polling stations in 2021 are 88,936. Percentage increases 34.73%. West Bengal, it was 77,413 in 16 and 1,01,916 now. The percentage increases 31.65%. Sorry? 1,01,916. And the percentage increase is 31.65%. Is it okay? Kerala, we had 21,498. Now we have 40,771. The percentage increase is 89.65. Because the population is so dense. The density of population is so much. Puducherry is 930. Number of polling stations now is 1559. The increase is 67.63%. Why, my friends, I am trying to mention this is that this also means that much more polling personnel, that much more security personnel, because the norms for the polling personnel and the security personnel remain the same. And although we try that, our CEOs try that the auxiliary polling stations, as we call them, are near the original polling stations so that we can kind of optimize on the utilization of manpower. You are all aware that after taking the inputs from several stakeholders, Commission had issued a set of guidelines for COVID in the context of COVID on 22nd August 2020. The inputs were taken from political parties as well as from our CEOs of all the states and UTs. We also mentioned in that whereas these guidelines are generally as per the NDMA guidelines and issued by Ministry of Home, but at the same time, as is mentioned in the MHA guidelines also, the states can make local variations and local changes, keeping in view their own milieu. However, this is the paradigm. We keep coordinating with the Ministry of Health and keep a very close watch on the health situation in the poll-bound states. The rollout of vaccination program has further contributed to a more positive environment as compared to earlier, and probably is gradually boosting the confidence of people for coming elections. I am glad to report to you that on the recommendations of the Commission, Health Ministry has already declared all our poll officials as frontline workers for vaccination. And the Commission has taken a conscious decision that after all our frontline workers are vaccinated, then only in the headquarters, it will start from the, let's say, from the MTS, the helpers, and the Commission will get vaccinated in the end and not in the beginning. Elections by definition involve large gatherings of people at various stages of electoral activity, whether it is nomination or campaigning. It is of paramount importance, therefore, to mitigate the likely health impact and reduce chances of transmission among the people. Several steps have been taken to address the issues. You are aware of most of them, but I'll still report. On October 29, as you are aware, on the recommendation of the Commission, the concept of absentee voters was introduced. Postal ballot facility had been extended as an option. I repeat, as an option to senior citizens aged 80 years and above, persons with benchmark disability flagged in the electoral roll, and electors occupied or employed in essential services. For example, metros, all these things which the local CEO identifies in close coordination with the DEC of that area, and those notifications accordingly made. Nodal health officers are also appointed at the state district levels to ensure all related arrangements and preventive measures during the entire electoral process. A separate SOP is there for the COVID-19 patients, suspects quarantined for their voting. That has already been issued by the Commission. Polling time has been uniformly increased. It was done in Bihar also. Again, also it's being repeated by 1 hour. And the decision is taken by the local CEO in close consultation with the DEC concerned. Several processes and procedures have been made available online in order to minimize person-to-person contact and prevent congregation of large number of people. But that doesn't mean that those people cannot exercise offline procedure for those things. The number of persons accompanying a candidate for submission of nomination has been restricted to 2, and the number of vehicles is also restricted to 2. Candidates later on can also seek electoral certification digitally besides filling the nomination form and affidavit online and the printout submitted to the RO. But as I said, these rights can be accessed offline also. Security money can also be deposited on the online mode. Door-to-door campaigning has been restricted to 5%, including the candidate. Roadshows are allowed, subject to the convoy being broken after every 5 vehicles. Ultimately, it is for the district magistrates, called collectors, called deputy commissioners, and their police counterparts, SPs, deputy commissioners, commissioners, IGs, who have to kind of finally take a view from situation to situation. But as I said, broad guidelines are there. DOs shall identify, which they have already done, the available grounds for the meetings. And DOs have been instructed, CEOs have been instructed to print a list of those grounds district-wise in the English as well as vernacular papers, so that people are aware which grounds are available in which state. To the best of my knowledge, the CEOs have started doing it in their respective states. Otherwise, now that the announcement is made today, they'll do it in the next 2-3 days. Adequate CAPF deployment shall be ensured during elections. All critical vulnerable polling stations have already been identified, and adequate numbers of CAPF will be deployed in such critical months, booths. Advanced teams are already deployed in these states and UTs. One day a news item came that some advanced teams have been sent to only to West Bengal. Then we released a press release that they were in fact sent on the very day to all the 5 states. So it was not that the team was sent only to West Bengal. So I don't know where it came from. In any case, you are aware that to ensure optimum use of CAPF, because wherever we go, we are told that the state administration, and this is uniformly said by the local representatives, that the state police, they do their own bit and they do not let the CAPF go to the critical stations, etc. So we issued a circular dated 8th February 2021, which is already in the knowledge of all of you practically. But I'll Shefali ji tell the request, sir, that it should also be separately loaded on the website so that everybody can see it. That circular says that now there will be a committee comprising of CEO, state police nodal officer, and state CAPF coordinator to jointly work out the election security plan and ensure randomization of the security personnel. Forced deployment plans of states and UTs shall be vetted by special general and police observers. For district deployment plans, both general and police observers will approve it. This will help in optimal and far more impartial use of CPFs in area domination, especially in the vulnerable areas and communities. Besides this, all other aspects of security management, including webcasting, CCTV footage, coverage, and videography, will be put in place. On 25th February 2021, Commission has directed by issuing a notification that arrangements for webcasting shall be done in all the critical polling stations and all polling stations in vulnerable areas, at least in the 50% such cases, including auxiliary polling stations, whichever is higher. I mean, if somebody can do 75, we should be too happy. If somebody can do 100, some of the CEOs did it. But 50% is the benchmark. It cannot be below 50%. You're also aware that ECI has had for some time a time-tested and robust system in deploying central observers over and above the district observers, special central observers for, depending on the sensitivity of a particular state, for law and order and for expenditure, etc., etc. In fact, in Bihar elections and in earlier elections also, in Maharashtra, in Gujarat, all these places, we had deployed such observers, and some of them did exceptionally well. In fact, one or two of them, most of them are retired members of CBDT or CBIC. Also, some of them have been in investigation in their own postings for a very long time. And such observers, this time I would like to take out the name of observers, Assam, General Observer, Shri S. Srinivasan, Odisha, belongs to Odisha, Kader Odisha, retired IAS from 80 batch. West Bengal, Shri Ajay Naik, 84 batch, retired. He used to be our CEO in Bihar and one of the best CEOs the commission ever had. Not that we have dearth of them, but he was one of the best of the best. Kerala, we are still finding out a person. We just have two, three options, but you have to take their consent. In a day or so, that will also be done. Tamil Nadu, Alok Vardhanji, Bihar 86, retired. Puducherry, Manjeet Singh, 88, Rajasthan. IPS observers, Shri Ashok Kumarji, IPS UT, 89 batch for Assam. Shri Vivek Dubey, 81 for Bihar. You would recall that Shri Dubey was observer in West Bengal in the last parliament elections also. Shri M.K. Das, IPS 77 batch, retired. He was earlier observer in Manipur, in Tripura, and under very different circumstances, and he acquitted himself exceptionally well. Shri Deepak Mishra ji, IPS retired, ECMO cadre in Kerala. Shri Dharmendra Kumar ji, IPS retired, he was special commissioner in Delhi also, ECMO cadre. He is in Tamil Nadu. Shri Dharmendra Kumar is from Tamil Nadu. Kerala, I am telling you. Kerala, Shri Deepak Mishra. IPS retired from 84, ECMO.
Sir, M.K. Das
ji? No. M.K. Das is West Bengal. Are you clear about IPS observers? Vivek Dubey, West Bengal. In fact, for West Bengal, we are having two special police observers. Shri Vivek Dubey, who was the special police observer in West Bengal during Lok Sabha. He is from Andhra Pradesh, 81 batch. Shri Minal Kanti Das, M.K. Das, 77, Manipur Tripura cadre. He also will be for West Bengal. He was our special observer in Tripura during the Lok Sabha elections. Shri Deepak Mishra ji, ECMO cadre for Kerala. And Shri Dharmendra Kumar ji, ECMO cadre for Tamil Nadu. I am clear now? Puducherry, we have not appointed anybody as yet. If only need be felt, we'll do it. But we presently think there may not be any requirement. And while taking the name of Shri Ashok Kumar for Assam, I mistakenly mentioned his cadre as UT 89. It is actually Tamil Nadu 81. I apologize for that. Now comes to expenditure observers. Srimati Neema Nigam, IRS. Neena Nigam, IRS for Assam. Shri B. Murli Kumar, IRS retired for West Bengal. If you recall, Shri B. Murli Kumar was one of those observers who had prepared a report which resulted in the recension of at least one election in Tamil Nadu. Shri Pushpinder Singh Punia, IRS for 85 for Kerala. Madhu Mahajanji, IRS retired 82, and Balakrishna ji, IRS retired 83 for Tamil Nadu, because Tamil Nadu is highly expenditure sensitive. And by the way, Balakrishna ji was also one of those officers when he was in investigations during his service who had prepared another report on Tamil Nadu, which resulted in the recension of one election. And these officers were there in Maharashtra also, they were earlier in Gujarat also, they were earlier in Bihar also, And Balakrishna ji, and we also conferred the National Voters Day Award on Madhu Mahajan ji. Am I clear? That is going to be a part of your questions.
We'll keep the questions later. Let's finish the statement first.
No. Expenditure sensitive. I will answer to you. Actually, I'll start answering with you only. Okay. I'll start with you now. If you want me to give the answer right now, I can give you right now. There has been no other state in that sense where two elections had to be rescinded. Vellore and Arkanagar. Arkanagar twice. Am I clear? While deciding the elections, the commission and our officials, we do try to accommodate, rather juxtapose, all the local sensitivities in terms of festivals, fairs, as well as the movement of central forces. Availability and movement of central forces. We cannot say that we make everybody happy by that, but we scrupulously try to, for example, avoid keeping an election in some states on Friday. That is the... And similarly, we have taken care of Bihu, Holi, Vishu, Easter, Good Friday, Ramadan, all these things they have been kind of trying to take care. Not only that, I would like to inform you that even when the exams for Central Board of Secondary Educations were being fixed, Umesh Sinha ji had a series of meetings, informal meetings or formal meetings between him and the CBSE authorities, and we tried to kind of see what their sensitivities are, and they try to accommodate what our sensitivities are. And the outcome has been that there has been a quite a kind of harmonious interaction in that regard. Commission would like to place on record the exceptionally kind of exceptional cooperation Commission has been getting election after elections in the context of availability and deployment of central forces, MHA, in the context of availability of wagons, Ministry of Railways, Postal Department, and many other agencies, can't name everybody, but they have been our kind of some of the biggest adjuncts with the commission, and they perform in the election duties as if they are also a part of ECI. We are really thankful to them. Commission has further strengthened 1950, our unified toll-free voter helpline to cater to all the queries of voters, including verification of name and polling booth in the electoral roll using its SMS facilities. As I informed you, during Maharashtra elections, the exact number of polling stations which we brought on the ground floor was 5,600. And we have made clear to our CEOs that this is something non-negotiable in view of the aged people and people with persons with disability. And I must say that CEOs have also risen to the occasion in Maharashtra, in Bihar, and all the states. I'm sure they've already done this. Assistance of volunteers, priority voting, electricity, ramps, wheelchair, and proper transport facility shall be made available to the PWD voters. Commission has been very insistent that the assured minimum facilities at each polling station, including drinking water, toilets, power supply, waiting area for ramps, etc., is made available, including in the auxiliary polling stations. Additionally, polling stations shall now be equipped with sanitizers, masks, soap, water, and other necessary equipment to handle any health emergencies. volunteers will be deployed to assist PWD voters, senior citizens, and COVID-affected voters. All necessary administrative and security safeguards have been put in place for EVMs and VVPATs, including randomization, FLC movement, and storage protocols, as well as multi-layer security cover. You are all aware that the Model Code of Conduct was evolved by the Commission in sustained dialogue with the political parties since the 60s. This is probably the only document which is a tribute as much to the political parties as to the then CECs or ECs, that this is a consensus document. The MCC shall come into force with the announcement of these elections. Commission has made adequate arrangements to ensure the effective implementation of MCC guidelines. Only in the case of elections, by-elections to the state assemblies, a separate notification shall be issued by Mr. Sinha and MCC shall come into force at that time. Criminal candidates with criminal antecedents are required to publish information in this regard in newspapers and TV channels on 3 occasions during the campaign period. It is also mandatory for political parties to publish in national and vernacular papers regarding individuals with pending criminal cases selected as candidates, along with reasons for such selection, as also why other individuals without criminal antecedents could not be selected as candidates. A whole lot of citizens groups, SHGs, Commission itself, and Honorable Supreme Court have been very persistent, and rightly so, in following this part. The expenditure limit for Puducherry would be 22 lakhs per constituency, and rest of the 4 states would be 30.8 lakhs. You would recall that in the run-up to the Bihar election, the expenditure limit was increased by 10%. You would also recall that over and above this expenditure limit as an immediate measure during the COVID period, it has also been decided by the Commission to utilize the services of Mr. Harish Kumar, a very senior officer from the IRS, who was Principal DG Investigation Delhi. He has already been working for the past more than a month, or almost 2 months, and has already given a very detailed, exhaustive report, which Commission has, in one of the meetings, accepted in principle and formed this committee of officers which we have, that now they will devise the modalities to implement the same within the coming month. Citizens are also requested to make extensive use of C-Vigil app to report any such illegal activity and inform us in case of violation of MCC or incidents of bribery, etc. You are aware that C-Vigil, which was started initially as a pilot project in Bangalore, has over the period of time during Lok Sabha was extended to the entire country and has now become one of the biggest tools of empowerment of citizens and voters. Media is one of our most important allies. I know you don't believe it, but I mean it. As I said, that we end up every visit to every state with an extensive briefing of interaction with the media. And that has been done this time also. It was done in the past. It is done this time. It shall always be done. Last time, if you remember, during Bihar elections, our senior officers, on the last day of counting, they kept on kind of briefing right till 12 o'clock in the night, besides whatever is available on the ECA website, in order that the media gets to know the results well in time. The same practice shall be followed this time in all these 5 states. Adverse use of social media platforms, you are aware of the challenge. New guidelines have been issued today by the government. We have requested Mr. Umesh Sinha, who had earlier been dealing with the social media platforms in the run-up to Lok Sabha elections and obtained from them a voluntary code of ethics which is relevant today also. But we have asked him and Dharminder Sharma, the two senior most officers, to study the guidelines issued by the government in detail so that we can align and juxtapose the both in harmoniously wherever possible to the advantage of the commission, whenever required to the advantage of the commission. Because, for example, we have a different timeline for deletion of news. So we'll kind of, they already kind of, they have got the guidelines and they are studying it. I think within the next 1 week, we'll issue a press release giving you the details of what they have recommended. You're all aware of the sweep program of the commission, and same things will be replicated this time also. I would not dilate more than that, because you know there are sweep icons, there are national icons, there are state icons, there are district icons. In fact, one of our national icons has also been awarded Padma Shri this time. Dr. Neeru Kumar, who is a person with disability, and besides being our NVD award winner, she has also been awarded Padma Shri. Before announcing the schedule for which you are actually sitting here, I would also like to put on record that I have personally been, this is, will be my last press conference before I lay down my, demit my office on 13th April. But I'll put the paint on till 13th April, forenoon, afternoon, how much I am allowed. And, but all this while, you have been real pillars of support to the commission in general and me in particular. And I also tried to engage with you individually as well as collectively, though not as much as required, because daily interactions are not possible. I would also like to tell you that I was associated with the election commission as election commissioner in 11 elections. And I had the good fortune to be associated with the election commission, including these 5 states, with 14 elections. And, of course, the assembly elections to Lok Sabha in 2019. So it was a kind of good innings. And I was looking through the old correspondence of my mother, and I found a sentence written in her own hand way back in 79. Unfortunately, she passed away in 89 of cancer. That was Alexander Pope's line, "Act well thy part, there all the honor lies." And also, "Kisi se hum sukhan hota nahi, mehfil mein parwana, unhe baatein nahi aati jo apna kaam karte hain." "Kisi se hum sukhan hota nahi, mehfil mein parwana, unhe baatein nahi aati jo apna kaam karte hain." That's the reason for less press conferences. Having said all this, I think Umeshji, I requested Umeshji last night at 12:30 in the night. Of course, he was in the office. I was also reading my papers. That this time, while I read out the dates to you, the same should be available on the large screen so that you face less problem in decoding the dates. Even if you face less problem, I'll repeat what you think has not been understood. Sudeep, are you ready? I'll start with Assam General Assembly elections 2021. Elections shall be held in 3 phases. First phase, issue of notification, 2nd March. First phase, 47 assembly constituencies, issue of notification, 2nd March. Last date of nomination, 9th March. Scrutiny of nomination, 10th March. Last date of withdrawal of candidature, 12th March. Date of poll, 27th March. date of counting, 2nd May. I shall not read 2nd May again and again because that is the date of counting is same for all the elections. Am I clear? Can I go to the next? Assam second phase, 39 constituencies. Issue of notification, 5th March. Last date of nomination, 12th March. Last date of withdrawal of candidature, 17th March. Date of poll, 1st April. If it is clear, I can go to next. It's clear? We can even read out the names of assembly constituencies, but that is going to be available to you, right? Assam third phase, final phase, 40 assembly constituencies. Issue of notification, 12th March. Last date of nominations, 19th March. Scrutiny of nominations, 20th March. Last date of withdrawal of candidature, 22nd March. Date of poll, 6th April. Now I go to Kerala. All elections in 14 districts consisting of 140 assembly constituencies to be held in a single phase as follows. Issue of notification, 12th March. Scrutiny of nominations, 20th March. Last date of withdrawal of candidature, 22nd March. Date of poll, 6th April. Am I clear? Go back to Kerala, please. Scrutiny 20th March. Withdrawal 22nd. Date of poll 6th April. Is it okay? By-election to the vacant seat of Malappuram parliamentary constituency shall be conducted simultaneously along with the Assembly of Kerala on 6th April 2021. Shall I go to next? General election to Assembly of Tamil Nadu to 2021. All elections to 38 districts consisting of 234 assembly constituencies shall be held in a single phase as follows. Issue of notification, 12th March. Last date of nomination, 19th March. Last scrutiny of nominations, 20th March. Last date of withdrawal of candidature, 22nd March. Date of poll, 6th April. If it is not clear to anybody, I can read it again. It's clear?
What about the parliamentary elections?
I'm coming. This was my next slide. Just watch there. Elections to the vacant seat of 39 Kanyakumari parliamentary constituency will also be conducted simultaneously along with the assembly elections on 6th April. Right? Puducherry, two districts, 30 assembly constituencies to be conducted in a single phase as follows. Actually, when we went to Puducherry, most of the political parties wanted that the election should be conducted along with Tamil Nadu because both sides probably felt unsavory elements coming in from this side or that side. In Tamil Nadu, being a far bigger state, this was the only major demand of the political parties in Puducherry. Anyway, I'll read it now. Issue of notification, 12th March. Last date of nomination, 19th March. Scrutiny of nomination, 20th March. Last date of withdrawal, 22nd March. Date of poll, 6th April. Friends, is it clear? West Bengal, 8 phases. Last time it was 7. No, that case was, I have the data with me, because I have to meet such intelligent people. That was split into 6A and 6B. It was ineffectively 7. It was split into 6A and 6B. You can take the statement from me after this. West Bengal, first phase. This will be 30 ACs. 30 ACs. Issue of notification, 2nd March. Last date of nominations, 9th March. Scrutiny of nomination, 10th March. Withdrawal of candidature, 12th March. Date of poll, 27th March. And those 5 districts are Purulia, Bankura, Jhargram, Pashchim Midnapur Part 1, Purvo Midnapur Part 1. Am I clear? Second phase, again 30 assembly constituencies. Issue of notification, 5th March. Last date of nominations, 12th March. Scrutiny of nominations, 15th March. Last date of withdrawal, 17th March. Date of poll, 1st April. And the districts covered are Bankura Part 2, Paschim Midnapur Part 2, Purvo Midnapur Part 2, South 24, Pargana Part 1. South Pargana Part 1. Are we clear? Shall we go to the next? Third phase, 31 assembly constituencies. Issue of notification, 12th March. Last date of nominations, 19th March. Scrutiny of nominations, 20th March. Last date of withdrawal, 22nd March. Date of poll, 6th April. Phase 4. 44 constituencies. 44. Issue of notification, 16th March. Last date of nominations, 23rd March. Scrutiny of nomination, 24th March. Last date of withdrawal, 26th March. Date of poll, 10th April. The districts covered are Howrah Part 2, Hooghly Part 2, South Pargana Part 3, Alipurdar, all the 5 assembly constituencies, Cooch Bihar, all the 9 assembly constituencies. Shall we go to next? Fifth phase. 45 assembly constituencies. Issue of notification, 23rd March. Last day of nomination, 30th March. Scrutiny, 31st March. Last date of withdrawal, 3rd April. Date of poll, 17th April. The districts covered are North Paragna, Part 1, Nadia, Part 1, Purbo Bardhaman, Part 1, Darjeeling complete all the 5 constituencies, Kalimpong, 1 constituency complete, Jalpaiguri, all the 7 constituencies. Shall we go next? Phase 6. 43 constituencies. Issue of notification, 26th March. Last date of nomination, 3rd April. Scrutiny of nominations, 5th April. Last date of withdrawal, 7th April. Date of poll, 22nd April. I can read out the districts again, although they are there in the slide in front of you, but I read out again since you asked. North Paragna Part 2, Nadia Part 2, Purbo Bardhaman Part 2, Uttar Dinajpur Part 2. All 9. Uttar Purbo Bardhaman, all 8, and Uttar Dinajpur, all 9. Shall we go to the next? Seventh phase. 36 assembly constituencies. Issue of notification, 31st March. Last date, 7th April. Scrutiny of nominations, 8th April. Last date of withdrawal, 12th April. Date of poll, 26th April. And the districts covered are Malda, Part 1, Mushirdabad, Part 1, Pashchim Bardhaman, all 9 ACs, Kolkata South, all 4 ACs, Dakshin Dinajpur, all 6 ACs. If you have gone through it, can we move to the last phase? Yes, sir. Issue of notification, 31st March. In all 35 constituencies, issue of notifications, 31st March. Last date of nominations, 7th April. Scrutiny of nominations, 18th April. Last date of withdrawal of candidature, 12th April. Date of poll, 29th April. 35. And the districts covered are Malda Part 2, Mushirdabad Part 2, Birbhum, all 11 assembly constituencies, Calcutta North, all 7 assembly constituencies. As I said in the beginning, only the counting shall be done on 2nd May 2021. And there are two more parliament constituencies, Andhra Pradesh Tirupati and Karnataka in Belgaum. Since MCC shall be applicable on the restricted these constituencies because the entire state is not going to election, Mr. Sinha will issue a separate notification for that. Just like they will issue a separate notification for all the by-elections to all the states. We have the figures as follows. We have the number of vacancies, etc. I can tell you, but in all it is 18 plus 4, all the constituencies shall be issued separately by Election Commission. Before I end, bhai back chal jao. आप एक मिनट बैठ जाए शिवाली जी. हो गया. बिफोर आई कंक्लूड दिस प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस आई शुड लाइक टू प्लेस ऑन रिकॉर्ड द फैक्ट दैट एज अ सिटीजन वन ऑलवेज रिस्पेक्टेड एंड लुक्ड अप टू द इंस्टीट्यूशन ऑफ द इलेक्शन कमीशन. हैविंग बीन इनसाइड नाउ फॉर मोर देन 4 years आई थिंक वन ऑलमोस्ट रिवियर्स इट. आई एम थैंकफुल टू माई फैमिली एंड फ्रेंड्स माई ब्रदर्स and sisters who have all been with me, and very, very thankful to both the commissioners. We had done it once earlier also somewhere, but that was optics. This is reality.
Sir, ek sawal hai.
Sir, ma'am.
Now, Shefali ji will take over.
Shefali ma'am.
Madam. Many of the statements.